10 most common mistakes in an MBA interview. Know them, avoid them, rather than commit them yourself, because lot of MBA candidates do end up committing these mistakes. I'm not going to touch upon the very basic mistakes such as not showing up on time, not wishing your interviewer, and I am rather going to focus on the more educated mistakes that the MBA candidates end up committing. Lack of expression. Frankly, I don't know any one strategy that can surely get you selected, but I know of one that will definitely get you rejected, and that strategy is to try to succeed in an interview by keeping your guards on. Trust me, this is not going to happen. The guys who are interviewing you are really smart individuals, and you can win in an interview only by expressing yourself, not by guarding yourself. When you do so, it reflects fear of being judged. So not talking, trying to get away with laconic answers are clear turn off, and they are a deal breaker. So please express yourself. That's the first rule. Number two, verbosity. MBA candidates love to talk, and therefore this is a very, very common mistake. The most common of all. Don't tell long stories in your answer. Emphatically state clear takeaways for the interviewer. Anything above 2 minutes per answer is a problem. Think of the US presidential debates. Those guys have to answer much bigger and more difficult questions, and all they get is 2 minutes per question. There is no reason why you should be taking longer than that. So imagine any question should be answered in 2 minutes or less. Mistake number three, beating around the bush. This is when you are speaking a lot but conveying little. Please avoid that. Ensure clear takeaways for the interviewer. Your answers must answer the question that has been asked. Be to the point in your answers. Don't provide extremely technical answers. The people interviewing you may not have a technical background. Talk like a generalist rather than a technical individual. Don't provide excessive details. Don't lose the plot. It's about effectively answering the question that has been asked. Number four, unidimensional answers. This is when your answers lack diversity. Example, the question is, describe yourself in 5 terms. And if your answer is on those lines, passionate, hardworking, dedicated, focused, energetic, think of it, largely these are all very, very similar things. The question allows you an opportunity to cover so many different aspects of your persona, but such an approach does away with the opportunity. Think on these lines. This is an exhaustive set of virtues that MBA admission committees honor. Come up with adjectives that cover different dimensions of your personality. Number five, sounding unprepared. A very common mistake. Lack of retrospection, introspection, contemplation, and these are reflected through taking too long to answer, thinking while answering, unidimensional, dull answers, beating around the bush. It is important that you come across as a thoroughly prepared individual for your MBA interviews, and the way you can do it is when you retrospect, which is to analyze your past, introspect, which is to analyze yourself, and contemplate, which is to plan the steps ahead in your life, your career. Number six is lack of takeaways for the interviewer. Do not kill the opportunity by giving subjective and vague answers about yourself. Try to give the interviewer concrete takeaways about yourself. So give rich answers filled with proper takeaways in terms of your skills, achievements, vision, clarity of goals, things like that. Enlist good 20 points that you would want to communicate during the interview. And think on these lines. And avoid keeping things subjective, wherever possible, quantify. Number seven, mistakes in etiquette. We have had a full video on MBA interview etiquette, and therefore I will run through this very quickly. The interview is often a friendly conversation. However, it is as formal as it gets. So do not assume liberties. Be respectful towards the interviewer. Be polite. Do not patronize. Don't indulge in an argument. Follow email etiquette. Follow telephone etiquette. Remember to send thank you email. Number 8 is not having a convincing self-description. Very, very important. Very often the first question that you are asked in an interview is on the lines, tell me something about yourself, or run me through your resume, or tell me about your work experience or about your current job. Ideally, this question should be in your comfort zone, but I very often see students struggling with this particular question. The common mistakes are long, never-ending answers. The most common mistake, often this includes thinking while speaking, narrating long stories around just one or two aspects rather than touching upon different dimensions about your personality. Going back and forth in time. Ideally, you must talk either in chronological order or reverse chronological order. Going back and forth leads to redundancy and it makes it difficult for the interviewer to understand what you are trying to convey. An unconvincing self-description is an opportunity squandered, the opportunity to make an impression, and the opportunity to guide your interview. A good self-description can very well define that how the rest of the interview is going to unfold. Number 9 is giving weak answers to key questions. Why MBA? Why the particular school? Post-MBA goals, strengths, weaknesses, examples of formative events, leadership example, ethical dilemma example, failure example, overcoming an adversity example, or a professional challenge example. These are key, almost expected questions in an interview, and not giving a convincing answer to these show a lack of preparation, and this can have a negative impact, a very negative impact on the result. Number 10, mishandling awkward moments. Remember, not the entire interview is going to be equally smooth. There are going to be awkward moments. As a smart interviewee, you must make sure that you do not let these awkward moments decide the fate of the outcome, and eventually you do end up leaving an overall positive impression on the interviewer. So if you are caught unprepared for the question, you should be able to handle that situation. When the interviewer grills you harder, please don't get defensive. It is only a good sign. Keep doing your best. Be willing to answer all the cross questions that the interviewer is coming up with. When the interviewer gives you feedback, accept it with utmost humility. Don't get defensive. Never question the feedback. Don't get into an argument ever. So these were the 10 most common mistakes. To summarize, here is a checklist once again. You may want to pause the video and just absorb the summary, the bigger picture. In the further videos, I would be talking in detail about how to avoid these mistakes. So that was the concept, guys. To get complete grasp over your MBA interview preparation, please watch all the 15 plus videos in this series. Thanks for watching.